In this video, we're going to dig a little bit deeper into electron configuration. In particular, we're going to talk about the Aufbau principle, which we really talked about in a previous video on electron configuration, but now we're just going to name it. And Aufbau comes from German. It really just means the building principle. How do we build atoms as we keep adding electrons? Now, in the introductory video, we saw that in the first shell, you only have one type of subshell, 1s, and that gets filled first. And then you go to the second shell, or the second energy level, and it has two types of subshells. It has 2s and 2p, but the two electrons will fill up 2s before you start filling up the p subshell. And the p subshell can fit 6 electrons, 2 for each of these 3 orbitals. And then after that, you go to the 3s subshell, and then the 3p subshell. And the third shell actually does contain a subshell known as the 3d subshell, and you can see d orbitals right over here. But it turns out that when you're trying to determine electron configuration, in most cases, 4s gets filled before 3d. And so to help us remember this, you sometimes see diagrams like this, where you do 1s, then you go to 2s, then you go from 2p to 3s, then you go from 3p to 4s, and if we kept going that, then you go to 3d, and then after 3d, you would go to, let me write that down here, 4p, and after 4p, you would get to 5s. So let me draw that just like that. But this starts to get us pretty far, because as we talked about, the s subshells can fit 2 electrons, but the p's fit 6, and the d's fit 10. So based on what we've just learned, let's get a periodic table of elements out and try to tackle some of the more complex elements. So as a warm-up, let's think about the noble gas neon. Neon is going to have 10 electrons. It has 10 protons and 10 electrons when it is neutral. And neon, being a noble gas, is very unreactive, so it's typically going to be neutral. And so where are those 10 electrons going to be? Well, the first two are going to fill that first shell, 1s2. Then the next two are going to start filling the 2s subshell, so 2s2. And then we have 6 left. And we know that the 2p subshell can fit 6. So then we would say 2p6. That's the electron configuration of neon. Now you might be noticing something. It looks like the elements in that first row, they are filling that first shell. Hydrogen, you're starting to fill that 1s, and then helium, you completely fill it. And then for the elements in the second row, it looks like you are starting to fill, and then completely fill with neon, your second shell. And then the third row, it looks like you're filling that third shell. And that, in general, is the case. That's one of the reasons why the periodic table of elements is so useful. But now let's build on top of neon. And we'll use our noble gas configuration as a shorthand. Let's think about the electron configuration of chlorine. Pause this video and try to figure that out. All right. So the shorthand, we could say, look, it's going to be built on top of neon's electron configuration. So it'll be 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, gets us that far. And then how many more electrons do we have? We'll have 7 more electrons. We've already placed 10. So then we start filling up the third shell. So we have 3s2. And then we have 5 more electrons. And that's going to go into the 3p subshell, 3p5. And that makes sense. We filled 1s, then 2s, then 2p, then 3s, then 3p. And what would argon be? Well, argon has 1 more electron than chlorine, so it'll just fill out that 3p subshell. So it would be building on top of neon, and then we get to 3s2, 3p6. So now let's do something that's a little bit more challenging, and it'll show this case where we don't fill the 3d right after the 3p. What about scandium? Pause this video and think about that. Well, scandium we're going to be building off of argon. Argon is the largest noble gas that comes before scandium. So let's build on top of argon, and we know argon's electron configuration. And so with argon, we have completely filled out the 3p subshell. We went from 1s to 2s to 2p to 3s to 3p. And as we mentioned from the Aufbau principle, we then start filling the fourth shell before, in most cases, before we fill in the 3D subshell. So when we start filling the fourth shell, let's see, to go from argon to scandium, you have three more electrons. So the next two are going to fill in the 4s subshell, so 4s2. And where does that last electron go? Well, that last electron, by the Aufbau principle, will start filling the 3D subshell. And so it's actually, if I wanted to write it in order of cells, I could write it fills in 4s2, and then it fills in the 3D subshell, so 3d1. So this is indeed the electron configuration of scandium. And that's interesting, because even though these 4s electrons are going to be further out from the nucleus, they get filled out before the 3D. And the way I conceptualize this is these Ds are happening in between these gaps in the Ps, and there's a lot of electron repulsion going on. So at least in this case, they're at a similar energy level. And that's true for all of these transition metals, which are also known as the D block. So these are the ones that when you get to it, you start backfilling the D block of the previous shell. So if you just look at the periodic table of elements without even looking at this little chart, we're filling the first shell with hydrogen and helium. And in both of those cases, it is the S subshell. That's the only subshell in the first shell. And so what we could do is let's put helium here for the sake of our argument on this periodic table. We could say, hey, look, in this case, at least in these first two, we're filling out the S subshell of our first shell. And then we start filling out the S subshell of our second shell with lithium and beryllium. And then we start filling out the P subshell of our second shell, where we start filling out 2P. Then we start filling out 3S. Then we start filling out 3P. Then we start filling out 4S. Then we, for the most part, and there are exceptions here, we backfill 3D. And then we fill out 4P. And then we fill out 5S. And so the way I just worked through it, you can see that all of these elements right over here on the left, there's a reason why these are called the S block elements. Because the incremental electron that's added when you have a neutral version of these, it's filling out the S block. And the reason why these elements, let me do this in a different color, why these ones that I'm circling in red, these are called the P block elements. When you go from carbon to nitrogen, it has one more proton, and if it's neutral, it has one more electron. You're filling that one extra electron into the, in this case, the 2p subshell. So that's what's going on in the p block. And then these transition metals over here, you've started filling out your fourth shell, but as you add electrons, and there's exceptions here, you are backfilling your d block according to the Aufbau principle.